With a brand new series. Can you guess by my outfit what we might be doing? But we aren't gonna stay here, we're gonna go out somewhere. Come with me. Whoa, did you guys run on the spot? You're probably better at running than I am. Welcome to our brand new series, Activate. This is where we are going to learn how to activate our faith. Some people say having a faith in Jesus is a bit like running a race. Lord, through life we face lots of different obstacles and worries, and this month we're going to learn about how we can take all those on with Jesus on our side. And we're going to have fun by doing that with lots of sports, because did you know there was supposed to be the Olympics this month, and we're going to bring all of that sport fun here on Kids Online. Now, what is your favourite sport? I've got a confession for you. I can tell you guys, right, you're listening well. I'm not very good at sports. I'm quite clumsy. I go to hit the ball and I miss, or I throw it and I think I'm gonna throw it to a person and it goes too far. But I have this magic screen that makes me be the best at all of the sports, and I want to show it to you. But we've got to travel there. So we're gonna click our fingers. If you can't click, you can clap along with me. Can you get them ready? In 3, 2, 1. Whoa, welcome to my magic screen. So this means that I can do whatever sport I want to do. So maybe your favourite sport is tennis, and I've just won Wimbledon. Or maybe your favourite sport is horse riding. Whoa! I don't know if I can control all those horses. Maybe it's swimming. Oh, I can imagine myself swimming across the Atlantic. Oh my goodness, I'm so good at swimming. Or maybe I'm winning the 100 metres in the Olympics. Yes! My magic screen allows me to do all of that. So why not talk to your family right now? What is your favourite sport? And if you could win any medal in the Olympics, what medal would it be? Magic screen. What did you guys say is your favourite sport? I'd love to know. We'd also love to keep in contact with you. As you may have noticed that we are now not specifically at 4 o'clock. We are Kids Online anytime. Whoa, how amazing is that? And that means we want to hear from you about what you guys are doing, how you're getting involved in the series. We've got lots of fun activity packs for you, so just go onto our website that will be linked here, and that will have all the information about how you guys can get involved with the series. But as always, we want to have loads of fun with our family worship, and we have got a brand new song written by some of our team. Whoa! So we're gonna have to jump over to Sophie. Are you ready? Get those knees ready. We need those to be good sportsmen. In 3, 2, 1, whoa! Pachow! Pachow! Pachow!
Welcome everyone to Super Sports with Sophie, where we get you warmed up for worship. Now, obviously, devastating news, the Tokyo 2020 Olympics cannot happen this summer, but fear not, we're gonna bring you all the sports action that you require. So, I'm just looking for a few sports experts, people who are gonna bring some enthusiasm, some athletic talent to this segment of the episode. And no, you guys are also sports experts. That is pretty impressive. So, let's ask these sports experts how they feel about the next part, which is gonna be a legendary workout, which we're gonna do with you guys. So, Caitlin, how do you feel about the big event?
I'm really excited. I've been training super hard.
Training super hard, that is pretty cool. And how about you, and how are you feeling about the big event?
I've never been more ready. I woke up ready to go.
She woke up ready to go. So guys, do join in along at home. We're gonna bring you a legendary workout to get us warmed up for worship. Let's do this.
This is something new, the Casper Slide Part 2, featuring the Platinum Band, and this time, we're gonna get funky. Funky. Everybody clap your hands. Clap, clap, clap.
time to worship together.
Friend King Dave wouldn't let the giant stand in his way. He said, hand me a sling, cause he's not that tall. My God's bigger and I'll watch him fall. My God's the king of the giants. My God's the king of the lions. My God's the king of the creatures of the deep. My God's the king of me. Have you heard the one about this guy called Dan? Yes, he was a mighty holy prey man. He said, throw him to the den of the scary beast. But God saved a hero from the lion's teeth. My God's the king of the giants. My God's the king of the lions. My God's the king of the creatures of the deep. My God's the king of me. History, he will do the same for me. Like Jonah and the whale at sea, when I'm lost and afraid, all alone in the dark, you're with me. Oh, you're with me. My God's the king of the giants. My God's the king of the lions. My God's the king of the creatures of the deep. My God's the king of me. My God's the king of the giants. My God's the king of the lions. My God's the king of the creatures of the deep. My God's the king of me. Reach in the sky and touch my toes. Spin right around and point to my nose. Run real fast, let everybody know I'm loved by Jesus. I reach to the sky, then touch my toes. Spin right around and point to my nose. Run real fast, let everybody know I'm loved by Jesus. I know he's beside me. I will never, ever, ever walk alone. Through him I can do all things. I reach to the sky, then touch my toes. Spin right around and point to my nose. Run real fast, let everybody know I'm loved by Jesus. Reach to the sky, then touch my toes. Spin right around and point to my nose. Run real fast, let everybody know I'm loved by Jesus. I know he's beside me. I will never, ever, ever walk alone. Through him I can do all things. Hey, I reach to the sky, then touch my toes. Spin right around and point to my nose. Run real fast, let everybody know I'm loved by Jesus. Run real fast, let everybody know I'm loved by Jesus.
Welcome to the new game segment of our Kids Online episodes, and this month we have got a treat for you. We have got a brand new game show, and it's going to be where we're looking for all the best sporting legends. It's called Activation Station, and let's cue the theme song. Welcome to the first ever episode of Activation Station. And I thought I could keep hosting this game show by myself, but I thought we'd bring in the big guns, someone that you may not have met yet, but I think we're going to be very good friends by the end of this series. So can you give a warm welcome for our brand new mascot? It's Bolt the Bear. Are you ready at home? Let's meet the contestants. So this week we have got a battle versus Team Football and Team Rugby. So representing Team Football today, it's Izzy. And representing
representing Team Rugby, it's Nat. So, all these guys know is that they are going to take part in a few different challenges to prove to see if they are the best sporting legend that we could find. But what they don't know is what challenges they are going to have to do. And I'm going to tell you, it's not what you're expecting. So, challenge number one is sock wars. So, you may have noticed behind me that there is a box of socks. And what we're going to do is give these guys 30 seconds and see how many socks they can get on their feet. Seems simple, right? How many do you think you'd get at home? Let's get going. Leaderboard. So, Team Football Izzy got 7 socks on in 30 seconds, and Nat, he did 10 socks in 30 seconds, so he is going through to the next round with an advantage. And so, as we go into our next round, we are playing a game of human Jenga. So, what they have to do is they are going to have a person to help them, one of them's going to have Bolt the Bear, and to see how many objects they can hold at once. Let's take a look. We've got one final challenge for them to take part in, and they're going to make a splash. What they have to do is there are going to be lots of cups of water in front of them, and we want them to empty those cups of water in the quickest time they can do. But their hands are tied behind their back and they can only use their mouth. How do you think they're going to do it? Let's take a look.
In 3, 2, 1.
Station this week is Team Rugby, and it's Nat! And in true form, we obviously can't let Izzy go just like this. So we found the biggest balloons that we can find, and let's see what's gonna happen.
Take a look.
All right,
My name is Daniel Dunno, but you can call me Danny, alright? And I've got a dream. I want to be the world's greatest sports commentator. I wonder if you know what a sports commentator is. Why don't you ask someone in your room while I look thoughtfully towards this window? What a sports commentator is, and I've been practicing over old YouTube videos of football goals. Take a look at this montage. I can't believe it, he's dribbling the ball and he's sending it to someone else. He's used his left foot, it's ridiculous. Whoa, he kicked that so hard I don't know which direction it went in. It's a goal. Whoa, that is most certainly a goal. Wow, that goalie must have really big hands. He scored a goal. I've never quite seen such a large amount of football under one game. So as you can see, I'm pretty good already. However, I've got a bit of a problem. When I've been trying to apply for jobs as a sports commentator to hopefully one day become a sports personality, they've been rejecting me. Apparently, I don't have enough sports knowledge. So I've got to ask you for a favour. I really want you at home to send me sports challenges. Maybe you could do a video and you could send me that and we could show it alongside my attempt. Or you could even just write it as a comment in the comments of this video, and maybe in a couple of weeks time I can give it a go myself. And this could be particularly funny. And here's for why. If any of you know me in real life, you'll know that I have no sports ability whatsoever. Honestly, my PE teacher used to tell people to pick me last for teams. Haha! So this could be really, really funny. So please, do send over your sports challenges for me, Daniel Dunno. You could call me Danny. And then hopefully in 2 weeks' time, you could see me do some sports. And we can raise my profile so that I can become the best sports commentator ever. I'll see you in a couple of weeks!
Charlotte, I've just finished trying to run my race, so why don't we go inside?
Well, that wasn't very easy. It was really hard trying to run carrying all of this stuff. I wonder what would have made it easier and more enjoyable. Can you think of what kind of things we can do to get ready for a race? We could put on our PE kits or our special running clothes. We could put on our trainers or our special running shoes. We could eat healthy foods to give us energy to run. We could do some stretches to get us warm so that we don't injure ourselves. And we can also take off anything that is heavy and weighing us down. I probably don't need these balloons. I don't think I need these roller skates. I probably don't need my sleeping bag. I don't think I need this rucksack. Whew! That feels better. The Bible says that life is a bit like a running race. And that doesn't mean that we have to be the best at running or hopping or skipping. And it doesn't mean that we have to get through it quicker than everybody else. But sometimes, just like me, we can end up carrying things that are heavy and weighing us down and that just get in the way of us going about our normal days. Sometimes they can make it hard for us to do our best and try new things. Our thoughts and our feelings can feel a bit like this too. Sometimes, if we're worried about something, those worried feelings can feel heavy, like they're weighing us down, and they can stop us from enjoying ourselves and having fun. I bet you're all really brave, but I wonder, can you think of one thing that scares you? Why don't you turn to the person next to you and ask them? To get worried sometimes, but God doesn't want you to be afraid because He loves you. God doesn't want us to feel weighed down. Instead, He wants us to be able to do our best and love our lives and have loads of fun at home with our families, with our friends, even at school. Here's one more question for you. What do you enjoy doing most? Why don't you tell the person next to you? Some things that are a bit difficult or might seem scary, but life is also full of amazing, fun things for us to enjoy. And because God loves us so much, He wants to help us take off all of those things that are weighing us down and stopping us from running our race so that we can live a life of peace and joy and freedom. For this week's challenge, I want you to take a piece of paper and write down all of the things that worry you or make you feel scared. And then I want you to scrunch it up into a ball and to put it in the bin. And I'm going to pray for us now that God will help us to do that this week. And if you want to join in at the end, just say Amen. Dear God, thank you so much that we are all different and we are all special. Thank you that we are known, seen, and loved by you. Thank you that we don't have to carry anything that is heavy and weighing us down. Please will you help us this week to take off anything that is weighing us down and to not worry or be afraid. Amen.
In my wrestling, in my doubts, in my failures, you won't walk out. Your great love will lead me through. You are the peace in my troubled sea. Whoa, you are the peace in my troubled sea. In the silence you won't let go. In the questions your truth will hold. Your great love will lead me through. You are the peace in my troubled sea. Whoa, you are the peace in my troubled sea. My lighthouse, shining in the darkness, I will follow you. Oh, my lighthouse, I will trust the promise, you will carry me safe to shore. will lead me through. You are the peace in my troubled sea. Whoa, oh, you are the peace in my troubled sea.
This week, and we're gonna screw it up, and then you can even practice your throwing and see how far you can throw it. Then remember to pick it up for your parents. But we'll be back next Sunday with a brand new episode. Get involved with all the activities that we've got on during the week. You'll find those on our website, and or message us at Kids Harbour Church on Instagram. We'd love to hear from you. But that's all from me. Have an amazing week. Bye.
Wow, that goalie must have really big hands! I like that one.
Oh yeah!
Welcome to Yoga and Pilates for Harbour Kids. Here we go, Eve. We're going to do this.